A steam train can be the future because of its past. The Industrial Revolution started because of steam trains. Just imagine travelling to Bluff and spotting a steam train coming towards you. Everyone loves steam trains. This proposed journey between Invercargill and Bluff will be the only daily steam train service in New Zealand. When the Bill Richardson Transport World was proposed, the future of the rolling stock in Kingston was destined to return home to Invercargill. Bill Richardson Transport World is bravely being built philanthropically in honour of the late Bill Richardson. Their philosophy is, build it and they will come. Jocelyn and her family will be forever honoured for this. Invercargill is gaining a reputation as a city of heritage wheels. The Bert Munro phenomenon took off after the release of the world's fastest Indian, which inspired the annual Bert Munro Challenge, along with the store historic displays at E. Hayes. This symbiotic partnership makes it very clear that the train from Kingston would be the icing on the cake. A daily heritage steam train journey to Bluff will capture the interest of national and international tourists, whom the Bill Richardson's Transport World will be attracting by default. This in turn will also increase passengers bound for Stewart Island, plus all those appearing on the screen now, once the City of Heritage Wheels is firmly established. The stage is set for the wholesale tourist market to establish itself here as a starting point to create tourism in a way the city has never seen before. Invercargill has 2,200 guest beds with a 70% occupancy. This will increase substantially, and the follow-on effect from that will mean a vibrant growth in the central business district, the likes of which we have never seen before. A heritage steam railway journey to Land's End, gateway to Stewart Island, will make Bluff prosper with shops and restaurants to enhance its reputation as the oyster capital of the world. There will be a fun-filled day for all at Stirling Point, Bluff Hill Lookout, the Marine Museum, and the return of the Powerhouse. This will entice tourist ships to the port and allow the train to steam their passengers back to Transport World. This restored vintage train must be a modern vintage train. It will be comfortable and have large LCD screens in each carriage to allow passengers to monitor every function by switching GoPro cameras. There will be free large broadband Wi-Fi to enable passengers to Skype friends and family. Each passenger will have the chance to purchase Devonshire teas and coffee and then get to keep the porcelain cup and saucer as a souvenir. It's all about branding. The charitable trust that will govern this train entity will be the property of the people of Southland and control the full restoration of the rolling stock from Kingston and manage the day-to-day running of the return service from Invercargill to Bluff. Presently, the proposed purchase of the rolling stock from Kingston is subject to a legal case which aims to change the current Queenstown Lakes District plan and allow the train's relocation to Invercargill. A good plan will have no trouble in overturning this current constraint, which is holding the rolling stock in Kingston. Originally, five of the seven carriages currently at Kingston came from Invercargill. It used to be the old Bluff school train for a period of 80 years. The rolling stock in Kingston has never had a full overhaul and is currently in bad condition. So for this reason, a full restoration by a local voluntary crew is required to guarantee the life of the train for the next 100 years of service. A number of true blue Southland people have already signed up to help restore the rolling stock from Kingston on a voluntary basis. Much valuable expertise has been acquired from the steam specialists in the North Island, Steam Incorporated and Mainline Steam in Wellington. who have put their hands up to guide us through the restoration process. These people also want this to happen. Locos 778 and 795 are close to their hearts. The workshop in Annan Street, kindly given to this entity by Richardson's, will be equipped to the highest standard possible. The voluntary crew that restore the train will be supplied with meals and refreshments daily. Goals will be set, and as each carriage is completed, the volunteers will be treated to celebrations. Comradeship will be a high priority. This must be fun. At the end of the restoration period, the voluntary staff will have the first opportunity to be members of the paid staff that will run the daily service to Bluff. It is very important to know that even though the train will be restored by volunteers, it must be run as a profitable business when it goes into service, and all the profit put back into the train entity to ensure its evolution and longevity. In the first 6 months, prior to the access of the rolling stock from Kingston, the workshop will be set up and the very best provisions made to accommodate the volunteers. Without volunteers, this entity will not succeed. The two locomotives and seven carriages will be trucked down from Kingston and most likely take the better part of a year to complete the restoration of the first carriage as a template, with number 2 and 3 overlapping after the first 6 months, with the completion of all 7 within 24 months. These are the sort of processes learnt from workshop visits to the North Island. Trains are not rocket science. Not like IT is today. There's nothing to be afraid of. The locomotives will have a separate restoration team. They will be restored within the same time frame as the carriages. However, special provision and fundraising may have to be sorted to overcome the many tasks to bring these classic AB locomotives up to Kiwi Rail standards. A water tower, turntable and the relocation of the old Tatar train station from Fairlight will be installed in Bluff. Invercargill has these three utilities by default, but there will be the installation of approximately 200 meters of railway track plus 2 switches in the workshop area. Environment Southland have advised that emissions can be offset, bearing in mind that the Earnslaw burns 14 tons of coal a day and the train only 1. Spike Consulting offer an independent railway staff training course which is recognized by Kiwi Rail. This is a compulsory management course, otherwise the train entity would have to be managed by Kiwi Rail staff at 4 times the cost. Only a good plan will succeed in gaining the right funding. This plan is a sitting duck for funding from the government's Tourist Growth Partnership, the TGP. The purchase and the full restoration of the rolling stock from Kingston will cost $3 to $4 million, a figure based on research to date. This entity requires 50 passengers a day to bring it into profit within 5 years. Volunteers, comradeship and pride will make this entity work. We must think big because now, along with Richardson's, we have a clear and present mandate to do so for tourism in Invercargill. Introducing the Green Hills Express.